Now, the Coalition of Aggrieved Customers of Men's Gold has reiterated its call on government to pay their locked-up funds. At a press conference in Kumasi, the group called out government's lackadaisical approach in dealing with their issues. They are asking to be paid from the consolidated fund.
From the consolidated fund before the end of October 2022, government asked the payment of our money in the 2020 mid-year budget for payment before 31st October. Three, propelling confiscate all assets of number one, sell it and return the proceeds to the state coffers. Four, we are, however, open for further discussion on the aforementioned issue by government relevant agencies. The media, all what we are saying, or the reason why we are gathered here this morning, that there is no peace within our houses. There is no food on our tables. People are dying. People are dying. Over 56 customers of Men's Gold have died out of this issue. And we are calling government, we are calling the state institution that they should be up and doing. We are citizens. We are not spectators. We are citizens. We are telling the government that enough is enough. If we stay in our homes, we are going to perish. And if we come out, we will perish. Then again, customers of Men's Gold, we have decided, or we are deciding that then we will come to the street and perish there. Because when we are in our indoors, we are perishing. We will not stay in our rooms and die. We will rather die on the street. So we are urging the government, we are urging the government that they should consider our statement. They should consider our plea. Enough is enough. And now one should never think that you go scot-free. 1,000 years to come, you will take our money. And now we are taking our money. Our money!
Our blood!
Our money!
Our blood!
Our money!
Our blood!
Let's go to Nana Sensu Mensah, who was at the press conference for us. He joins us via the phone. Tell us more about the concerns of these customers, especially their concerns with how government is dealing with the matter. Nana.
Yeah, Daryl, the aggrieved customers of the fine gold dealership, they are saying that, actually, they said so many things, but let me just categorize them into four. So first of all, they want government to pay them from the consolidated fund before the end of October 2020. Also, the aggrieved customers are saying that government should, you know, add the payment of their money in the 2020 media budget for payment before October 31st. And then also, they want government to confiscate and sell assets of Nana Apia Mensah, that is number one, and then sell all his assets and return the proceeds to the state coffers. Lastly, they also say that they are opening up to government and its relevant agencies that they have mentioned issues that they have put before government. They are opening up for interested to discuss with them. They are also up for that discussion. So basically, that is what they are saying. They are also alleging that government is somehow in bed with the defunct gold dealership firm owner, number one. That is why government has dropped all the 61 charges that was leveled against him in court. So in all, they are just quite disappointed. And then they are also calling all their members, their family members, and then also all their relatives that they should massively, you know, register their ongoing voter registration so that they can acquire their card. Mm. And then decide whether to vote for the government or vote against him. That will depend if the government heeds their call before October 2020. So basically, this is what they are pouring out to the government.
All right. Thanks for the update, Nana Sensu Mensah from the Ashanti region, of course, where Men's Gold customers are not happy with how government has been dealing with the issues with their locked up funds.